Good morning, students. In my last video, I have discussed about the basic concept of polynomial, like the definition of polynomial, the degree of the polynomial, zero of the polynomial, and all the same time we have discussed also how to find out the zero of the polynomial by three different methods. Now it is a turn to learn what is called remainder theorem. Remainder theorem is such a method through which we can find out the remainder when the two polynomials are divided without actual division. In class 8 you have studied to divide two polynomials. I would like to ask you one question. What is a method or what is the way to stop our division? At which point we will stop our division? Suppose I say x cube minus 2x square plus 4x minus 1 divided by x minus 1. Let us divide x square, x cube minus x square, minus plus cancel, minus x square plus 4x minus 1, minus x minus x square, minus minus plus x, positive negative cancel, 3x minus 1 and plus 3, 3x minus 3, minus plus cancel, this is 2. So do you see at what place I have stopped division? At what place I will feel that this would be the remainder? When you find the degree of the remainder is less than the degree of the divisor. Understood? When the degree of the remainder is less than the divisor, then we stop division. But there is no question here in this particular topic to divide actually. The same question we can see without actual division, we can find out the remainder too. What is that remainder theorem that we have to learn? Let Px is any polynomial of degree 1 or equal to 1 or degree more than 1 of degree more than 1 or equal to 1 and A be any real number, then real number if Px, that is called polynomial in X, is divided by X minus A, then PA is called, PA is the remainder. Suppose X minus A, A is what, a real number? When you are going to divide this PX, PX is what? It's a polynomial in X. That's why I have taken here x minus a. If p y is there, then I will take here y minus a. If z is there, we will take z minus a. It is carry on. So in this case, pa is the remainder. How it comes? What we do here is we try to find out the value of x by equating 0. X minus a is equal to 0, therefore x is equal to a. That shows that when you put the value of x in this given polynomial as a, whatever the value is coming, that is what is called the remainder. Similarly, if suppose you have, if the polynomial Px is divided by x plus a, then the remainder is P minus A. How it comes? See, x plus A is equal to 0, so x equal to minus A. Similarly, if the polynomial Px is divided by Ax plus B, then P minus B by A is the remainder. How it comes? Ax plus B is equal to 0, so x equal to minus B by A. If the polynomial Px is divided by A plus Bx, then the remainder is P minus A by B. Therefore, here how it comes, A plus Bx is equal to 0, Bx is equal to minus A, x equal to minus A by B. Now, what is called factor theorem? Theorem. If Px is a polynomial of degree more than 1 or equal to 1 and is divided by and A is any real number such that Px is divided by x minus a, then if Pa is equal to 0, then we say x minus a is the factor of Px. If suppose I say 2 is a factor of 6, on what ground we say? When we divide this 6 by 2, it is exactly divisible. And when exactly it is exactly divisible, what is the remainder? Remainder comes 0. So that is why this is what is called PA. PA is called remainder. And if this remainder, after getting this 0, then we can say it is divisible. Conversely, if PA is, if x minus a is a factor, then Pa is equal to 0. Here it is. So Pa is equal to 0, then x minus a is a factor. If x minus a is a factor, then Pa is equal to 0. That is the same, almost same thing. So these are two important facts. The remainder theorem, factor theorem will come together. We will discuss the problem based on this. So first of all, I'll discuss the problem based on the remainder theorem, how to find out directly the remainder. I will compare. Problems on remainder theorem. If Px is equal to x to the power 4 minus 3x cube plus 2x square minus 4x plus 3 is divided by p minus half, then find the divided by 2x minus 1, then find the remainder. Sometimes it happens that a polynomial is written directly, it is not named, but you will name it, then it is easy for us to write down the statement. And in this case, the statement is very important to note. Now, since Px is equal to 2x4, 3x3, 2x square minus 4x plus 3 is divided by 2x minus 1, then can you tell me what is the remainder? Then p half is the remainder. How it comes? 2x minus 1 is equal to 0, 2x is equal to 1, x is equal to half. Now, p half, wherever x is there, from right to left, you put it half. 2 is equal to 2 into half to the power 4, 3 into half cube, 2 into half square, minus 4 into half plus 3. Now 2 into 1 by 16, 3 into 1 by 8, plus 2 into 1 by 4, minus 2 plus 3. This is 1 by 8, 2 1 jar, 2 8 jar, minus 3 by 8, plus 1 by 2, plus 1. Find out the LCM. 8, 1 minus 3 plus 2 4s are 4 plus 8. How much is 8 plus 4? 12, 1, 13 minus 3, 10 by 8, 2 4s are 2 5s are 5 by 4 is the remainder. You don't need to divide it. Let us take another example. If Px is equal to x cube minus 4x square plus 3x minus 4 is divided by x minus 3, then find the remainder. Same statement, right? Since Px is divided by, what is your Px stands for? Px stands for x cube minus 4x square plus 3x minus 4. when px is divided by x minus 3, then what is the remainder? P3 is the remainder. What is left here? X minus 3 is equal to 0, x equal to 3. Now, so px is equal to, you have x cube minus 4x square plus 3x minus 4. P3 is equal to 3 cube minus 4 3 square plus 3 into 3 minus 4, 27 minus 9 4 is 36 plus 9 minus 4. How much it is? 9 7 16 36 minus 40. How much? Minus. So when you divide it, actually also you will find the remainder is minus 4. Let us take another type of question. What is that? Let fx is equal to 3x cube minus 2ax square plus 4x minus 1 and gx is equal to 2x cube minus 3x square plus 2x minus 1 are divided by x plus 2 such that, here is it ax, such that the remainder comes out to be 0, comes out to be equal, not 0, to be equal. Find a. Since we have two polynomials and the both of the polynomials are divided by the same polynomial x plus 2, but the, what is the condition? Condition is given that the remainder is in both cases the same. I will just make an assumption that in the first case the remainder is R1 and second case is the R2, and at last we will take R1 is equal to R2. So let us see. Since fx is divided by x plus 2, then f minus 2 is the remainder. Therefore, fx is equal to 3x cube minus 2ax square plus 4x minus 1, f minus 2, 3 into minus 2 whole cube, 2 into a into minus 2 whole square, 4 into minus 2 minus 1. Let us say this remainder is your R1. So what will happen? Minus 8 is the 24, minus 4 to the 8a, minus 8 minus 1. R1 is equal to how much? 9. 34, 8, 12, 33, minus 8a. Equation number 1. Now, again, gx is equal to 2x cube minus 3x square plus ax minus 1. G minus 2 is equal, because we have the same. We have the same. Better you write down the statement. It is better you write down the statement. Since gx is divided by x plus 2, then f minus 2 is the remainder. So therefore, gx is equal to 2x cube minus 3x square plus ax minus 1. G minus 2 is equal to 2 into minus 2 whole cube minus 3 into minus 2 whole square 2 into minus 2 minus 1. This is suppose R2 and minus 8 to just 16. 4 is a 12 minus 4. Oh, sorry, it is AX. It is A. So minus 2A minus 1. So R2 is equal to how much? Minus 29 minus 2A. 6 to 8, 1, 9 and 2. So this is equation number 2. According to the question, what do you have? R1 is equal to R2, means both the remainders are same. R1 is how much? Minus 33 minus 8A, and R2 is equal to how much? Minus 29 minus 2A. This will come down, minus 8A plus 2A, minus 29 plus 33, minus 6A is equal to 3936, so 1394, and therefore A is equal to 4 by 6 minus 2 to 3, that is minus 2 by 3 is your A. This is another type of question. One more type of question I will discuss. Let fx is equal to 2x4 minus 3x square plus 4a plus 3 is divided by two x minus 3 and gx is equal to x cube minus 2 x square plus 4 x minus a is divided by x minus 2 such that R1 and R2 are their respective remainders. Find the value of A such that 3R1 minus 2R2 is equal to 4. Question is same, but such conditions are given little bit. That's all. Same way we will go, same statement we will write. What will write? Since fx is divided by x minus 3, then will you say P3 by 2 is equal to R1? How it comes? Look at here. 2x minus 3 is equal to 0, so x is equal to 3 by 2. Similarly, fx is equal to 2x4 minus 3x square plus फोर ए एक्स प्लस थ्री, सो एफ रादर इट इज एफ नॉट एफ पी, थ्री बाय टू, टू इंटू थ्री बाय टू होल फोर माइनस थ्री इंटू टू थ्री बाय टू होल स्क्वायर प्लस फोर इंटू ए इंटू थ्री बाय टू प्लस थ्री, दिस इज कॉल्ड आर वन, दिस इज टू इंटू ट्वेंटी नाइन फोर नाइन जै एटी वन बाय सिक्सटी, इट इज टू माइनस थ्री इंटू नाइन बाय फोर प्लस थ्री सिक्स ए बिकॉज टू टू जा फोर एंड प्लस थ्री एट टाइम्स, सो आर वन इज इक्वल टू एटी वन बाय एट माइनस ट्वेंटी सेवन बाय फोर प्लस थ्री प्लस सिक्स ए. दिस वन इज सिंप्लीफाइड, आर वन इज इक्वल टू एट, दिस विल बी योर एटी वन माइनस फिफ्टी फोर प्लस ट्वेंटी फोर प्लस फोर्टी एट ए. सो आर वन इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच यू सी, एटी वन प्लस ट्वेंटी फोर, हंड्रेड एंड फाइव माइनस फिफ्टी फोर वन फाइव, सो इट इज फिफ्टी वन प्लस फोर्टी एट ए डिवाइडेड बाय एट, इक्वेशन नंबर वन. Similarly, if you go for the second one, what will you say? Since gx is divided by x minus 2, then x g2 is equal to r2. Gx is equal to how much? X cube minus 2x square plus 4x minus 8, and g2 is equal to 2 cube minus 2 square plus 4 into 2 minus 8. This is r2, according to the question, r2 is equal to 8 minus 4 to the 8 plus 8 minus a, 8 it cancel, so r2 is equal to 8 minus a. So according to the question, what do you have? 3r1 minus 2r2 is equal to 4. 3r1 is 51 plus 48a divided by 8 minus 2 into 8 minus a is equal to 4. Now multiply each of the term by 8, so it will be 3 into 51 plus 48 a minus 16 into 8 minus a is equal to 32. Now this is to be solved. 3 1 ja 3 15, 3 5 ja 15, 3 8 ja 24, 3 4 ja 12 and 4 16, sorry, 144 a minus 128 plus 16 a is equal to 32. Let us solve here. Forty-four and 16, how much? 168 is equal to 32 plus 128 minus 153. 168 is equal to 8 to 10, 3 to 5, 16, 153. That is 7. So A is equal to 7 by 116. That is the answer. So these are some different questions which I discussed today in the
remainder theorem. Some more question will be there next video, and after that we will discuss the factor theorem. Thank you so much.